Hello, Emirates wannabes, and hello, Wishcasters. Welcome to another episode. Today, we'll be answering a couple of questions. They were asked by Francesco Ricigliano and by Georgia Gray on YouTube, Francesco on our Emirates Facebook. It's Emirates Wannabees Forum. If you want to join us and ask us any question, we do answer to all of your questions. We're doing videos on Wednesdays and Sundays. If you want to join us with our video premieres, join us, ask any questions. They will be replied live. So the questions were regarding the roster. How many days off do we get per month? And can we bid for days off during our probation? And can we fly home during probation? And how many days off can we bid consecutively? A lot of people might not know what probation is. Probation is a period of time where the Emirates cabin crew is tested. He's checked upon to ensure that his performance is at high standards. Standards that Emirates taught you through the training, they want to make sure that they are met throughout all these flights during the 6 months period. This will be evaluated through these flight reviews. So every, I think, maybe 8 flights, I really don't know, it depends. It's randomly assigned. They will do a flight review and they will see how you're dressed, if you're smiling in the cabin, if you're doing everything properly, if you're following the service sequence properly. If you keep this at a high standard and you never get a bad review, then after those 6 months, the probation is over. So you're considered a normal cabin crew. During the probation period, you may not bid for days off, you may not bid for flights. However, I think everybody does. All of our class did. They say that you shouldn't, also because it doesn't work. After your probation period, you can bid for days off and you can bid for flights. However, you have a maximum of 5 bids. Very high, then you have high, then you have medium, then you have low, and then you have very low. These are the 5 types of priorities that you can assign to every bid. Whatever you put like very high, it's sort of the one that they will try to award you. The fact that you get that flight or those days off is based on the period that you ask for. So if you're asking for a very competitive flight and you're asking for a very competitive period, let's say Christmas, if you bid for New York, it's gonna be really hard to get because New York is already hard to get, plus Christmas is really hard to get. It's gonna be really hard for you to get that flight. In the past, they used to give you days off, but nowadays it's really hard for you to get any of those days off, unfortunately. You can bid up to 5 days off consecutively. What you can do is put your days off next to leave, so you can have combined days off with leave. They usually give you 1 day off before and 1 day off after your leave. In the past, they used to give 5 days off before and 5 days off after if you bid for it. That was really good. Nowadays, this doesn't happen anymore. You can bid for 5 days off consecutively, but it's really hard to get. Usually they give you 3 or 4. Today we're in Prague, Czech Republic. We were walking along this river. This is the main river. It's called Vltava, and just next there's a golf course, and this is where we come and play golf sometimes. It's just a shooting range, so you shoot from there and you have to throw it as far as possible, and this is where the padding area is. It's where you use accuracy and get it in the hole. So today you're gonna be with us playing golf a little bit, and I'm gonna answer your questions as I play golf with Zdenk. He's here. Ciao, Zdeni. Another question that has been asked by Francesco, I believe, is can you take your own food on board? Of course you can. I think it's healthier, especially if you're on a diet. Don't forget that on board you have fruit, you have strict vegetarian, you have vegan meal, you have fish, you have chicken, you have beef, you have lamb, you have several different types of meals that you can have. This link in the upper right corner is our masterclass series on joining Emirates. It's free. It'll always be free. And it's a gold mine. Trust us. Follow it from the beginning to the very end. Francesco, you also asked me if we have any rosters, any samples of rosters that are quite recent. And yes, we do. We're going to be showing you the last 2 months of a roster, and we'll show you also some rosters from 3 or 4 years ago. So you can compare how many days off were given in the past and how many days off were given now. So these are rosters from the past.
XX means day off. LV is leave, and the 3-letter codes are the airports you're flying to, so your actual flights. While the small little arrows indicate that the flight will be continuing on the next day, on the following days. These rosters are proof that in the past there used to be many days off throughout the whole month. You may also notice that you have 10 days of leave followed by 5 days off. This is something that used to happen all the time in the past. Now, doesn't happen anymore.
And this is a roster from nowadays, I think last month or this month.
Not only there are fewer days off, and it's clear that there are fewer days off, but also you have fewer days off before your leave, meaning that you cannot slack off and you cannot really relax and enjoy your holiday. You're constantly thinking about work.
There are lesser crew and same amount of flights on a regular basis, so you will tendentially have less days off at the moment. It's going to be tougher. When you join, you'll see it's going to be tougher. But still, you're young, so it's going to be fine for you. Don't you worry. Another question Francisco asked me is the roster in the probation period the same as a normal roster, regular roster, when you're not in probation? And the roster is exactly the same. Doesn't change anything. The only thing is that you can't bid and you can't go home. So if you have a lot of days off, you can't go home. Hi, Georgia, if you're watching this video, there's the answers to your questions. So one of your questions were, when you go to sleep in the aircraft, do girls remove makeup and then reapply it, or do they keep it on while they sleep? As you fly with Emirates and as you do long flights, every second of sleep is precious. So I'm very sure that maybe the first few times you might remove your makeup, but then you'll stop doing it because it takes up too much time and it's precious time that you'd need to sleep. When you wake up, you'll be replenishing the makeup that came off on the pillow or whatever. How is the life in Dubai? How do you get around during your days off? Do you have any time to visit Dubai? In the past, we had more days off. Now we have lesser days off, so it's tough to go around Dubai and enjoy it. So many of my friends haven't even been to the Burj Khalifa and they live in Dubai. So as you can see, there isn't much time, but at the very beginning, since you're young, you'll have so much energy, you'll be happy. So you'll be able to find that energy. As time goes on and you progress in your career, you start to realize that you need that sleep and you'll eventually stop having all that energy to spend on visiting things, and you'll dedicate it more to sleep, to your work. You'll be spending more time at home, I think. Anyways, if you wanna see the things we've done in Dubai, that we have some videos going on and you can check them in the link just right now popping up. And that's what we did. Those are the videos that we've done in Dubai on our free time. Most of those videos had to find the energy to go out because I was like, oh, I don't wanna do it. I was so tired, but I did it. With dedication and sacrifice, you can, on your time off, visit Dubai. You can roam around and see it for yourself. Even though you will be tired, I'm not gonna hide that. There was another question by Georgia regarding the use of gloves, if you can or you cannot, while collecting trash on the floor. In the past, you were not able to use your gloves in any circumstance, only when dealing with medical emergencies or vomit, diarrhea. This topic has been discussed and they have agreed on the use of gloves during final clearance and clearing the cabin and picking up blankets from passengers, as it is quite dirty. Like when you're picking up a blanket from the floor, you never know if there's a vomit in it or there's a poop in it, or when you're picking up trays, you constantly get your hands dirty because of juices or sauces. People have begged the management to introduce them and now they finally get to use them, so you can. When you're in your sleeping pods in the crew rest compartment, when you're going to sleep, can you watch films, read magazines, read newspapers, books, stuff like that? And the answer is yes. When you're on your time off and passengers cannot actually see you, you can practically do whatever you like. As long as you're not working, you can do whatever you like. And this other question that Georgia asked us was regarding fatigue. How do we handle fatigue? This is a very tough question and it's all depending on the person. There's a lot of people that can handle fatigue in a really easy way and a lot of people that have a super tough time in handling it. For example, for me, it was quite easy. I would have energy no matter what time, no matter what time of the day, I would always find energy. And I say the job for me was one of the easiest ones. The toughest part was on board. I would feel so tired, I would almost fall asleep on the jump seat when we were landing, which is very dangerous. But for example, my girlfriend, Zenka right here, she had trouble with fatigue. She had trouble with jet lag. She would come back to Dubai and not have energy for anything. The only energy she had was sleeping at home and cooking and meeting with her friends, and that is it. It'll all depend on you, ultimately. Okay, I hope I answered all your questions and I hope you enjoyed this episode. If you did, smash that like button. It really helps me and makes me feel proud of these videos, because sometimes I don't know if anybody's watching them and is liking them. If you haven't done so, subscribe to our YouTube channel, join our Emirates Wannabees group, ask your questions. And as you can see, you've asked your questions and I've replied. I've taken my time and I've replied to every single one of you. If I forgot to reply to any questions, let me know in the comments below and I will reply. For now, that's it for my video. I hope you liked it. If you have any other questions, just post them in the comments below. Subscribe, hit the like button. I will see you on my next video. Ciao. Thank you for watching till the very end. We thank you for your support and following. It's oxygen for us.